was too low. That could have produced some of the balls we've seen.
Motioning to raise it.
Unbelievable. There are standards that the equipment must fall within.
They just moved it. The all-around was tainted.
No one wins the all-around gold with a fall.
Oh, game over. No gold medal for Svetlana Horkina.
Now, Svetlana Horkina has given up her spot in the vault final. When eight women get the chance to show what they can do when the vault is right. They had an odd demeanor when they checked its height, but they did it nonetheless. Simona Aminor of Romania, out to defend Olympic gold. Esther Moya eliminated Australia, but Spain's never won an Olympic medal in gymnastics. Andrea Radican won gold in Romania's all-around sweep. Confidence counts for a lot. Elena Zamolotchikova gets another chance with help from Horkina. The Russians believe she has a better vault. It's another opportunity for her to deliver. Then, there's the face to remember, the one of Ekaterina Lavrentyuk. Eight women in the vault for gold, silver, and bronze, and a chance like that. A slot in the starting order is like gold itself, that opportunity. And Svetlana Horkina has given away her spot for her teammate, Elena Zamolotchikova, because she believes, and the team believes, that Zamolotchikova has this chance, what Horkina called a once-in-a-lifetime chance, to go and get a gold medal. Horkina will perform later on the uneven bars, but this opportunity has been handed to her teammate, and she remains in the seats to cheer her on. The biggest early upset of these Olympic Games in gymnastics was Australia not making it to the team final and getting a chance to rock the Superdome. The reason they didn't make it was that Esther Moya stuck her vaults when it all came down to her. And she eliminated Australia.
And now this is a brand new vault that was submitted here in Sydney.
Beautiful vault, tremendous power. Has an excellent body position in the air.
And an excellent chance of winning a medal in the event final. She actually qualified first. Mentioned those start values. This one has a start value of 10.
9.762 on the first vault, very high score.
Her second vault actually drops a slight bit in the start value. The maximum she can get is out of a 9.9. Oh, that's unfortunate. Typically shows a lot more power than we saw in that second vault.
I don't know if she got her hand set right.
Couple of steps forward on that landing. Just really didn't have the rebound off of the horse that she needed to get her body rotated enough. If you have to sum up how much time these gymnasts spend on their second vault versus what they do every day, day in, day out, it's
very little.
It's very, very low.
A score of 9.619.
And now the all-around silver medalist from Romania, Simona Aminor.
Defending gold medalist on vaulting from 1996. There have been very few competitions on vault where Simona Aminor's name was not in the mix. There are a few opportunities for athletes to repeat their title from 96. She's one of them.
And Tim, this is a big vault. She's planning a 2.5 twist. Wow, that is too bad.
And what that comes down to, she adds a half twist for a little bit more difficulty, but that's going to really damage her score here.
And that is really surprising because the Romanians typically don't take that kind of risk when they know a gold medal is on the line.
You see that 2.5 twist. I've heard of only one other gymnast in the world who's performing that vault.
Here's the all-around gold medalist, Andrea Radakan. This has been her coming out party these Olympics. She's getting set to go. Aminar gets a 9.625 on vault number one.
Most of the athletes will choose to do the vault there a little more comfortable with first. Get one under the belt.
Big, big problems today on the landing.
Yeah, it doesn't look like she will repeat here.
Very uncharacteristic.
That's cruelly how it is in vault. In the blink of an eye. Coming up, Zamo's second chance. The women's vault final continues and we'll have a new Olympic gold medalist. Simona Aminar's 9.537 won't get it done in this game. Now, if you earned a spot to go for a medal, would you give it up? Elena Zamolotchikova knows the answer to that when it comes to her teammate Svetlana Horkina. Horkina thought that Zamolotchikova had a better chance to win a medal and told her this is the chance of your lifetime to go and get it. And she gave her spot away. Now, Zamolotchikova cried when she thought she didn't make the all-around. Got in when an injured teammate allowed that to happen. She didn't make the most of that. This is her second chance. Rough landing.
It's deceiving though, Al, because it's an incredibly difficult vault. Even though she hops, she's still gonna get a big score. Double twisting Sukahara, so much going on here. Look at the height. She's gotta spot the ground, and yes, she does hop. But that vault is not gonna hurt her.
Remember, in the event finals, the athletes have to perform two very different vaults from two different families. That's what makes it so difficult.
Joaquin is into this. She's got a lot invested.
Zamo's second vault is actually out of a 9.9. Remember, that's the maximum score she can score. Yurchenko with a double twist.
Oh.
That's more like it.
You know, if there's been one thing that's been missing from these games, are finishes like that. That's how a gold medalist is supposed to land.
This is the type of landing that we saw from Zamo at the World Championships last year. Check out the twist, so quick in the air, so tight, beautiful form, and bam, plant it.
Check out Svetlana Horkina, who talked to her about this being the chance of a lifetime. How about making the most of this chance?
Yeah, she gets part of that gold medal, I would say, if this works out in the end.
We always know what she's feeling. And she's feeling joy for her teammate, 9.75. That averages out to a first place score. Zamolotchikova in first place. Katerina Labuznyuk, 17 years of age, Russian teammate.
And what a surprise. She's planning to do the same two vaults that we just saw from Zamo, first one being her most difficult.
But don't assume that because two are doing the same vaults in a row that they're easy. They're not. Well, it was a nice vault, but nowhere near the explosion from the horse into the air.
And if the judges want to be picky, right here, watch the landing. She pikes her body down. They can take a deduction there. She didn't stay stretched and laid out.
And a little bit sloppier than we just saw from Zamo.
So let's see. Zamolotchikova got 9.712. She gets lower than that, indeed. 9.662.
She'll also perform the same second vault that we just saw from Zamolotchikova. A double twisting laid out Yurchenko. Big power, just maybe piked down a little bit too much at the end. She really had that landing and kind of scooted her feet underneath her.
I thought this vault was actually a much better looking vault. Great twist at the top, but just a little bit too relaxed in the knees and takes a shuffle on the landing.
She's really got to come out of her shell, I'd say.
So. I think she thinks it's not up to Zamolotchikova's score, and she is right. Lava's beautiful average, 9.674, but it's Russia, 1-2. Still to come, the all-around champion from these games, Andreea Radican of Romania. Coming right down to it in the women's vault final at the age of 16, Andreea Radican stood there on the podium as the all-around gold medalist. And Romania stole all of Russia's thunder. The Russians ripped off their silver medals, and it was all because of the Romanians. And right now, Russia's making a statement in vault.
Little bit.
Yep. Wow. A little short.
That was amazing, though. She was high on the horse.
That's the same vault that we saw from Esther Moya. It's the new vault that was submitted here at the Olympic Games.
Wow, I am amazed that she was able to put this all the way around to her feet.
She actually had trouble in the warm-ups tucking her legs quite severely.
She's a little bit high on the horse, but she knows how to flip this around.
This is going to be close if she can pull off another one like that. The first vault, 9.725.
Now her start value goes down slightly from a 10 to a 9.9. The last minute coaching from Octavian Bellew.
Oh boy. She needs to be a 9.731 average.
If you're gonna take a step, it's better to step either a little bit forward or a little bit backwards. If you step both backwards and to the side, it shows that you have actually two errors going on, not just one. This one done from a straight handspring. But you see that little slide off to the side. We've seen that before.
No,
close.
No.
Nope.
She is in second place behind Zamolotchikova. So then Radican and then Lavoznyuk. She got a 9.662 on that second vault. And there is a hug from Zamolotchikova to Radican and Lavoznyuk. Only one more to go, and it's Laura Martinez of Spain.
It's going to be really difficult for Laura to even factor into the medals. She doesn't quite have the same start values that we've already seen from the stronger competitors.
First vault is nice, though. Double twisting Yurchenko.
Her most difficult. Does it well. Laura was actually a finalist at both the World Championships last year and this year's European Championships, placed eighth in both those events.
This Spanish team has really dramatically improved in the last few years, qualifying into the final team round and actually placing ahead of Ukraine, who has been a longtime power in women's gymnastics.
First vault, 9.662.
Second vault, her start value actually drops by a tenth. It's only out of a 9.8. That's the maximum.
And that's really going to hurt her as she's trying to catch the score of Lavoznyuk.
It's going to have to be perfect.
Oh, and look for a moment there that she was going to stick it cold.
When you do a lower start value vault, you have to really try to secure that landing. She almost had it, but oh, was leaning over to the side, was forced to take a step.
And that's going to make it official. Laura Martinez will miss the medals, 9-6-1-2. And how about that? Zamolotchikova gets handed this extra chance. Octavian Bellu, the coach of the Romanian team, knows his gymnast, Andreea Radican, finishes in the middle. And that big smile of relief from the Russian women as they finally make their presence felt here in the vault. Zamolotchikova gets that extra shot from Svetlana Horkina and delivers the gold to her Russian team. And delivers it with style.
Still to come after this break for your local.
The diva of the Russians hit bars on night one like nobody else to qualify for today. The drama of her performance is born in a place where you learn to be tough. In the team finals, problems arose. So did her anger. With a silver medal that didn't seem right to her. In the all-around, the Russians were blown away. She dropped out of sight. What about now? Elena Brudinova hasn't had the Olympics she was supposed to. A big reason why? A bad foot. Now she's running out of chances to make an impression. From the time she was small, Ling Jia has had that special something on the uneven bars. Now she flies into the final. Their nation has been energized by their team performance, and we'll see just how high she can go on her own. Those are the major players for the women's uneven bars final. Eight women, one routine, gold, silver, and bronze. Svetlana Horkina knows the deal. She hasn't lost on the uneven bars in a major international competition since the middle of 1994. That includes a gold in Atlanta at the Centennial Games. She will come later. We'll begin with Victoria Karpenko of Ukraine. Two times a medalist in this event at the European Championships.
And she also had some struggles at this competition. Going into her last event, she had a shot at winning the all-around title, stumbled on the floor, and couldn't keep the Ukrainian streak going.
And settled for 12th in the all-around.
And this is it for her in the Olympics. Last opportunity.
For all these event finalists, their routines will begin out of a 10.0. What it will come down to is the choice of skills, just how well they will perform them, and most importantly, can they stick the dismount? Really tough to start off the competition, and when you take steps like that on the landing, you're not gonna see a really high score.
Yeah, this bar final is just jam-packed with incredible talent. Anybody that makes a mistake has a form deduction. They are not gonna factor in. First release skill right here, a ginger, and then transitions to the low bar, and look at her knees, they bend a little bit, come apart. Very strong exercise, but this is not one that's going to win a medal.
Some of the bios these gymnasts bring with them to the games are unbelievable. Victoria had a coach in 1993 in the Ukraine. One day he didn't show up at the gym. They never heard from him again, ever. She gets a 9.775. Now to the 1997 American Cup champion, Elvire Teza of France.
And she actually has introduced several moves. She'll show us one midway through this exercise, swings with incredible speed and power.
Very aggressive bar worker.
Gonna come up right here. This is called a German giant. This is her
great
own skill. Watch this.
Wow.
So much speed.
Whoa.
a little bit too much.
That's too bad. Remember, she's in such fine company, but this skill is pretty awesome. German Giants.
And that skill is her very own. The ironic thing, she loses a tenth on it because she does break form.
And it hurts her score, 9-5-1-2. Still to come, Svetlana Horkina, as the uneven bars event final continues. The women's uneven bars event final continues now with Yang Yun of China. That's Ling Jia. She's coming up later in this same event, yet she's out there making this preparation of the bars a team thing.
Well, you got to remember, these athletes, they live together, they train together, and, you know, they're probably their best friends.
Yang Yun in the all-around competition had a fall on the balance beam, came very close to meddling in the all-around if it wasn't for that fall. Told her coach she still gets teary-eyed every time she thinks about just how close she got.
Chinese have the best lines in the world on the uneven bars. Excellent toes and just complete and total extension. Look at that position right there.
Textbook form, and check out the release skills. Beautiful height, great extension right down to her toe point. Yeah. That's what it takes in event finals.
She's digging it.
And this Chinese delegation on both the men's and the women's side has overperformed.
And we have loved the enthusiasm of the Chinese gymnasts, men and women.
Beautiful extension. Skyrocketing on this release skill. You know, one of the reasons the Chinese have been more successful here, I feel, they took a lot of the pressure off the athletes. Unthinkable, but they actually skipped some workouts because they felt that the pressure was getting to them.
There's your leader, Yang Yun, 9-7-8-7. And now that's the score everyone has to chase. Here's an even different look at the teamwork. Elena Prudinova of the Russian team helping prepare the bars for Tatiana Zhaganova of the Belarus team.
You got to remember that they used to be one country and they're very friendly, speak the same language, and their coaches were from the same system, and many of them have lifelong relationships.
Tatiana has been in this position before. Last year at the World Championships, she placed eighth in the world on uneven bars. Has a really aggressive style.
A lot of these pirouetting elements right into the release skill.
That's where they get their bonus points.
And look at that.
That was great control.
That's the goal, go right to the handstand. She probably stayed in the handstand maybe even a little too long, but this is
really impressive.
An awesome routine.
Keeping her legs glued together on all her elements. This is a nice set.
Whoa.
Yikes.
That was, wow, I thought she was gonna hit her feet on the bar there.
That handstand was amazing. It's like she hit the pause button.
A lot easier to balance when you have perfectly open shoulders like she does. Everything just kind of goes into place. You know, she's just like hanging out.
Nine, seven, three, seven. That will put Zhaganova in second place. And now Svetlana Horkina is getting serious to defend her Olympic uneven bars gold medal.
902.
The women's uneven bars event finals. There are your leaders. And next up is Olga Rushapkina of Ukraine. We've talked an awful lot about gymnasts leaving home, and many people who believe in the nuclear family in the United States don't understand it. In the case of Olga Rushapkina, both of her parents right now, tough times in their country. They live in a small village south of Kiev. They're unemployed. They sell what they can on the streets. Dairy products they collect somehow just to make ends meet. So gymnastics has meant a chance for her to see the world, things she never would. had she not taken up the sport.
Olga is actually known to many of her gymnastic friends as the Little Lilia, of course referring to Lilia Pokopaeva, who was the 96 all-around champion. She has a bit of that same look.
And how can you not root for her to do something that could maybe change the way her family lives?
She's gonna have to be absolutely perfect because she was seventh coming into these finals.
But here today, of course, best score wins. Everybody started fresh.
Dismount.
This is a big one. Oh, we know just how valuable those extra tenths are.
Had a good day in the all-around, in the top 10, placing eighth. But overall, it has been a disappointing Olympic Games for Ukraine.
Big upset by Spain, beating Ukraine out of that fifth position.
And Roshapkina's score is a 9.725. That will not be medal worthy. All right, we come down to the big moment. She started brilliantly. She hit a 9.85 to qualify. And then Svetlana Horkina missed twice in the team finals, in the all around. They had the vault controversy when it wasn't high enough, and then after the stumbling on the vault, she went over to the uneven bars and fell, not knowing that the vault had been wrong. This is her redemption routine.
And it is nonstop, jam-packed, original skill like that after original skill.
That's the way she envisioned it would happen in the all-around.
She can't do it any better than that.
Everyone said that if she hit tonight, this title would be hers.
Her longtime coach there, Boris Pilkin, stuck by her, she says, when everybody else gave up on her. They went back home, put in new skills like this one right there to have the opportunity to compete with the best in the world. Looks like it's paying off.
And that rhythmic clapping has been the crowd signal that they have loved what they've just seen, and they want the judges to put up a huge number. She had the highest score, remember, 9.85 to qualify for this event final. There it is, 9.862. That ball is out of here. But it's tough to read her reaction. The challengers that remain include her teammate, Elena Prudinova, who had her all-around opportunity snatched away because of a bad foot. Her Olympics has come down now to these event finals. And then there's Ling Jia, of whom it's said she has the best bar set in all the world. She comes out of the Chinese system, and she's built for the moment that lies ahead.
Congratulations to yesterday's winner of the all-new 2000.
Svetlana Horkina of Russia, trying to salvage a gold out of these Olympic Games. She's in the top spot. We come down to the last two in the uneven bars event finals. For Elena Prudinova, it's been a career filled with great gymnastics, but on her list of competitions is a lot of seconds, thirds, and fourths. We talked about your body doesn't know what you're putting it through, and this was one of those times when her foot didn't know that she was supposed to be in perfect health for the Olympic Games.
She had a string of fourth place finishes at last year's World Championships, one of them being on the uneven bars. She's really going to have to be exceptional if she's looking for a medal.
This is different. She does it with her legs together.
Really aggressive. Oh, and that's a major mistake there.
When she transitions from the high to the low bar, she changed the skill. All these judges know what she's supposed to do.
You can see it in her body language.
These judges have watched her routine thousands of times, and believe me, they are not going to be fooled by the miss on the low bar.
Borkina's still waiting. She gave up another opportunity earlier in the day to a teammate, Elena Zamolotchikova, who won gold in the vault.
Now this release skill, very different for her. She keeps her legs together, rare in women's gymnastics. She transitions to the low bar too close, swings around the bar there. You see the form break and almost stops. Those are built-in deductions. And at this point, she's thinking, I just would really like to get off the bars, because she knows there's no way she can challenge for the top spot or even a medal of any color.
You can almost see it on her face right after the mistake in that replay. Now Ling Jia of China, she is the only one, in addition to Svetlana Horkina, who scored a 9-8 or better to qualify for this event final. And she is the last challenger to Svetlana Horkina's gold medal hopes in this event.
Totally different style you're going to see here. She has really pushed the envelope in certain skills. They're called inverted giants. Really revolutionized this, made it more popular, and just about every top bar performer in the world now incorporates moves that she perfected.
Ling Jia also said that in order to win here, she would have to be perfect.
Look at the extension, and now right into a release. All day yesterday spent training, and the thing she worked on was the landing of the dismount. Comes up right here.
Almost.
Is it going to come down to that one little step?
I'm afraid it's going to come down to that one little step.
And how many times have we been saying that here in the Superdome?
It was a great exercise.
Beautiful release skills and great form, but not quite the same originality as this lady.
Borkina wants to have her fist on it. She's got it. Ling Jia, 9837. Told that she just proclaimed this is for the people of Russia. Before these Olympics, Svetlana acknowledged that things were not that great back at home, and that maybe through sport they could make people in Russia feel a little bit better. This outstanding Olympics continues for the Chinese Ling Jia and Yang Yun.
Знаете, она долгожданная для всех россиян. Для меня я эту победу дарю всем россиянам. Но это немножко моя победа сейчас немножко это закрыла. Немножко, но это не забудется никогда. Я буду это вспоминать всю жизнь. Что принадлежало мне, что сделали против меня.
I'm told Svetlana said, I've waited for this medal a long time. I give this victory to all Russians. This win makes me feel a little better, but I will never forget the all around and what they did all my life. What belonged to me, they took away from me. But they can't take this gold away. the pressure of being America's best. That is what Elise Ray understood for the first time this week. At her Olympics, nothing seemed to go right. She said, "My shoulder popped out." The current national champion, she is expected to be the rock for the United States team.
Oh my gosh.
Pick a word way above costly, and that's what that fall was. Tonight is Elise Ray's last chance. The threat of Russian power and grace is what Elise Ray is up against. Here in Sydney, Elena Prudinova and Ekaterina Lavoznyuk have taken their hits. Now, it's time for a comeback. China's Liu Xuan is in her second Olympic Games. Her coaches thought she was too old, but they brought her for her experience, to be a foundation. To hold up the team. And then there was one American left with a chance to medal. That is it, and the opportunity belongs to Elise Ray in the balance beam event final here at the Superdome. She is going over and over, and right there going over the part of the routine that she fell off of in the all-around.
And not just in the all-around, but just moments ago in warm-up for beam, the same element once again giving her some troubles. Hips out of alignment.
10 seconds remaining. Hips up.
10 seconds left in her warm-up. You have a scheduled amount of time that you can take before your exercise, and then no more beam. So she went over to the floor. Best place, best option she had left.
So now here it is. The last American gymnast in these Olympic Games to compete.
And there is a lot of talent in this event beam finals. Elise, unfortunately, has the disadvantage of going up quite early. And coming up after this skill right here, when she walks down to the end of the beam, is the element we've been talking about.
Three skills in a row, flip-flop, layout, flip-flop. Perfect.
The only one in the competition to do this skill, a double turn, huge risk.
Looking good, right?
Very good. She has the disadvantage of going early. All she can do is her very best job, and so far, she is.
Another combination coming up right here. And she misses her connection.
That means the skill immediately following that front, she omits, loses some difficulty.
And possibly a lower start value.
That's too bad, right? Till just about the very end, looked like a great routine for Elise Ray.
It's the first time I've seen Kelly Hill go up to a gymnast after a routine and have nothing to say.
And there was no problem in the first tumbling run, the one that gave her the problems in the all-around and in the warm-up. Obviously, that extra bit of work on the floor helped her.
So difficult, though, this double twist, and she connects it right into a little jump. But here is where the problem was. She's supposed to
connect another jump right out of it in order to get the valuable bonus points.
And for the first time since 1972 in the Olympic Games, the United States will not win a medal. And those are Jaylin and Janelle Dancher, the twin sisters of Jamie Dancher, 7 kids in that family. And Everybody in the Dancer family breathing a sigh of relief. Father John and Jamie's sister Jennifer were in a car crash with a bus. Jennifer is out of the hospital. John is in stable condition. Our best thoughts with them. He hopes to be out of the hospital soon. You've seen those powerful images of Svetlana Horkina and Elena Prudanova taking off those silver medals from their necks just seconds after getting them in the team competition. This, the beam, is where it all went wrong for Russia. And Ekaterina Labozniuk was one of those who made a mistake.
All these athletes have remarkable stories on how they got to the game. Her started, her mom coached her for her first 5 years of her career, and then at a competition where she fell time after time, she was spotted by Valery Dianov, took her to Siberia along with the entire family, changed their whole lives, and then on to Moscow to the National Training Center at Round Lake with Leonid Arkayev.
And Tim, he obviously recognized the great talent that he had on his hands. She has such variety in this routine, including a spectacular skill coming up right here, the only one to do it.
Little bit long, definitely too long of a pause. You can see why though.
I think I'd pause too if I was going to do that.
This is a great exercise and just her dismount left.
And there he is, Valery Dianov, the man who took her from Siberia to Sydney.
I love that face.
Fantastic exercise, Al. This was the skill that was just so awesome.
Jumps half turn in the air, then does a front flip and somehow finds that balance beam.
The judges liked it a lot. 9-7-8-7, she takes the lead. Her teammate Elena Prudanova is next. Bothered by a bad foot in these Olympic Games, if you look at her career, the one thing she needs is to stand on a big time podium on the gold level and be there by herself. Yeah, I know you're the head coach of Russia, but I'd like this shot, please. Thank you. Unbelievable.
And we watched her in the training sessions heading into these competitions. The first time I had ever seen her cry was in one of her training sessions on balance beam. That foot was just taking a beating.
Gotta be a little bit uncomfortable because of that injury. She's got one tumbling shoe on and one off.
Close save there.
She's got the coolest eyebrow in the Olympic Games, and she says it's cut that way to make her look like a warrior.
She told me it's supposed to be like that, Tim.
She is all about power, determination. Great skill coming up right here called an Anodi. Very difficult, saves it once again. She is not falling off this balance beam.
Takes a different path than most of the gymnasts. Running double front off the end of the beam, very hard to land.
That's tough. They lead the league in kissing. So, was it good enough?
Well, it was a great exercise. There were a couple of visible errors in the routine where she had to actually save the elements, but she did a great job covering up.
Another one of the trickiest elements being done on beam. This one's been around for a long time, though. It's called an Anodi. named after the great Hungarian gymnast Henrietta Anodi, jumps that half turn in the air and then does a front handspring step out of it.
But nobody does a dismount like this. Double front, fantastic. What makes it so great is she just sticks it.
You see that eyebrow I was talking about, and she'll lose this by an eyelash. 9.775, 12 thousandths of a point behind Lebeznyuk, her teammate. Liu Xuan of China will be the last gymnast to go. Represent better the spirit of doing it for your country than the Chinese men and women. Based on their past Olympic performances, they have achieved beyond their wildest expectations. The Chinese women's team was comprised of young gymnasts and a veteran, Liu Xuan, back from the Atlanta Games in 1996. She's given every indication that this is it in her Olympic career, and so this would be then the final performance.
And Al, you saw that score, the needs, 9.788, very possible for her to achieve.
She does a number of elements where she loses sight of the beam, tips her head back, very difficult. Also, big tumbling run right here.
Oh, that was gorgeous.
Here comes one of those elements right here. Very difficult.
Liu Xuan is wrapping up a career that she believes her mother could have had. She was a top flight gymnast, but during the Cultural Revolution in China in 1968, the gym was closed down and the door was closed on that opportunity.
Her mom wanted to travel to Sydney to watch her daughter in probably her final gymnastics competition, couldn't get a visa. So she's at home watching on television.
One last move.
What a way to go.
Regardless of if she wins a medal here, this has been the most successful Olympic Games for this, both men's and women's Chinese team.
And what a great way for Liu Xuan to end her career. Check out this tumbling pass. What made it so spectacular is she actually tumbles the length of the balance beam but maintains a beautiful laid out position until her feet hit the beam. That was great.
And during that pass, Lin Jia wanted it for her teammate real bad. And after the dismount, they were exuberant, the men and the women. So what's it going to be? It's going to be a gold goodbye.
I venture to guess not in her wildest dreams.
Liu Xuan takes the gold, Yekaterina Lebeznyuk the silver, Yelena Prudinova the bronze. They thought they needed a veteran to help show the kids the way, and they were right. Liu Xuan showed them how it's done. And the Russian women don't want to stop there. This is the floor exercise event final. Everybody with one routine for the medals. Svetlana Horkina, bigger in stature, bigger in presence than everyone else. And now she has support from home. Her sister Julia, interestingly enough, wearing a USA sweatshirt, sits in the upper deck. And then there's Elena Zamolotchikova. Imagine if it came down to her and Horkina on the floor exercise.
Could very well be the case, but it's a strong women's field in these event finals on floor. But what's amazing to me is every time Svetlana takes to the floor, it gets very quiet in the arena.
Only a handful of athletes could pull off the type of routine. Very dramatic.
Thank you.
with her being so much taller, she can present an entirely different line than anyone else in the competition.
She takes full advantage of that.
And she's ready for her close-up, Mr. DeMille.
It never fails. She always draws me into her floor routine.
Saw her in training before the Olympics began. Saw some of her new elements, saw her new floor routine and music. She looked over to Elfie and I and said, so what do you think? Well, we think it's good, and I'm sure the judges will as well.
She opened the door just a little bit with this second tumbling run, a triple twist. What she gives away is the landing.
Maybe not quite as fresh as she was, obviously, at the beginning of the Olympic Games. Looks a little bit tired, but she hangs on to it.
9.812. Svetlana Horkina sets the bar, but there's a lot of talent to come. Back at the Superdome, we continue with the women's floor exercise event final. Here's the all-around gold medalist. These games have been a coronation for Romania's Andreea Radican.
She has a perfect blend of choreography, difficult skills, and what she does that no other Romanian gymnast does is express herself.
And the story in the women's all-around was about all the falls, but this young lady was the only one who could do this all meet long, land on her feet. That will take her not only out of the gold medal race, but she will not medal on floor.
Win her a medal here today.
There's the very successful coach of the Romanian women, Octavian Belu.
These combination tumbling runs are so critical. Your body needs to land in the right position, or you just can't get the bounce that you need. And she is too far back on that, not enough rotation, and has to pull extra hard. takes that step forward and the hands down.
And Andrea Radakon gets deducted down to a 9.275. Not near the medals. Svetlana Horkinas, 9.812, remains the top scorer. Now, earlier tonight, Spain won its first ever gymnastics medal to defer in the men's vault. Now here's Esther Moya, and we've talked an awful lot about how she eliminated Australia.
The leader of the Spanish team, and no question she was instrumental in helping them finish fifth in the team finals.
Congratulations to yesterday's winner.
And Esther Moya of Spain puts herself in second place with two gymnasts to go. The crowd here thought 9.7 should have been higher than that. The lead remains Svetlana Horkinas. Elena Zamolotchikova will come after Simona Aminar of Romania. She scored the highest on floor exercise than any of the other competitors in the qualification on night one. 9.8.
And what she does in this floor exercise is she gets great height in her tumbling.
Oh, right on the perimeter.
And remember, the line is in. Arrived in Sydney, her coach Octavian Ballou thought that she had the best shot of any of her athletes to win event medals on vaulting and this one right here floor.
Final tumbling pass. This is what it all comes down to for a medal.
Out of bounds.
Where's the flag? And it has been raised.
On the very last step.
Taking the risk, full twisting double somersault at the end. Very few athletes doing that in this competition. She's gonna pay the penalty though.
High level tumbling in the entire routine, but taking the step out of bounds, as you said, Tim, it's going to take you out of a gold medal.
9-7-1-2. She moves into second place. Now we have a very bizarre Russian scenario. Yesterday, Svetlana Horkina had a spot in the vault event final. The next highest qualifier on the outside looking in was Elena Zamolotchikova. Horkina and the Russian team thought she had the best chance, chance of a lifetime, they called it, to go get a gold medal, and she did. Now, Horkina's in the gold medal position, and Zamolotchikova's in the same event with a chance to knock her out.
Double twisting, double somersault, right off the bat.
And she has struggled with trying to stay in bounds, and she continues to stay in. Wow.
Olympic gold medal until this pass right here. Perfect today. Stick this pass and she goes home with two Olympic gold medals.
So close to that corner.
Oh.
Now she'll have tears of joy today.
Just a matter of crunching the numbers. It looked like she was looking for someone to hug or high five or kiss or do something. There was nobody there.
Devastated after the first day of competition, didn't make it into the finals. Devastated when her team didn't win the gold medal. It all turned around when Svetlana Horkina gave her shot at her first gold medal on vaulting, giving up her spot.
9.85, she's the gold medalist. Horkina was congratulatory, but never got out of the chair. Where is everybody?
She just wants someone to hug.
Where's Arkayev? Interesting. She beats Horkina for the gold. Aminar takes the bronze, and Esther Moya of Spain misses a medal by 12 thousandths of a point. Finally, the hug from Horkina. But where was Arkayev?
The compulsory Arkayev kiss after the win, missing because he's in the back gym, warming up Bondarenko and Nemov for high bar.
But he was watching. A bumpy ride for the Russians, but finally, in the end, vindication.